pathognomonic pain characteristic. Central poststroke pain. A typical chronic pain condition caused by ischemia injury is known as central poststroke pain or CPSP. It's possible for the damage to manifest anywhere in the brain, from the brainstem and thalamus to the primary somatosensory cortex. The diagnosis of CPSP is obtained once imaging reveals a distinct brain lesion in conjunction with recognizable painful symptoms that are unrelated to peripheral disease. It's important to remember that individuals may have a mix of central and peripheral pain etiology area. The painful area may be small, but it's usually affect a large area of the body that doesn't have a sclerotomal, myotomal, or dermatomal distribution. There are many types of pain onset, including acute and delayed. Unfortunately, the duration of CPSP may be persistent and there are few reliable effective therapy choices. Central pain does not have a pathognomonic pain characteristic. However, frequent descriptions include persistent burning, acute paroxysmal shooting, and aching sensation. The severity of the pain is always extreme, but in most cases, the quality of life is significantly impaired. Depression, irritability, and sleep disturbances are common symptoms. The majority of researchers believe that somatosensory system disturbances are what lead to central CPSP. Deficits in muscular control, coordination, vision, hearing, vestibular function, and higher cerebral skills do not affect central pain. The emergence of central pain does not need the presence of non-sensory symptoms. Ectopic activity theory and neuroplastic alteration are two of the most often discussed causes for the sensory alterations. The ectopic activity is caused by the spontaneous or provoked firing of neurons involved in the processing of somatosensory information. The patient feels pain as a result of an imbalance in sensory neural input and disrupted synaptic connections. The activation of NMDA receptors by excitatory amino acids is what causes the neuroplastic alterations and hypersensitive states that happen during and after nerve damage to the somatosensory system. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.